life, you're putting it on a plate, you're giving it to God. What's on that plate? Is it like shriveled up little mashed potatoes and like, I don't know, pasta that's been left out for a month or something all moldy? Or is it a fresh, like, bomb plate where God's like, tight? He just starts pounding it, right? Starts pounding it, putting it down like you guys do in the nighttime during dinner. They told me, the camp staff, you guys ate more than anyone ever in the world. Your ordinary life. And let me ask you this. Why do you think it's important? Why do you think it's important that you live for God in your everyday ordinary life? Let me let you know what it is. Basically, it's this. Is someone once said this. They said, the best message that you could ever preach is your life. Right? How did he do it? He was like that. He was like skipping. And then guess what? It wasn't like you expected. It wasn't like you expected, or seventh grade, it wasn't like you thought it was going to be. You know what, there's these people, and man, you know what, and there's this like drug stuff, it's a little green, it comes in a bag, and there's like girls that are like, are cute, and guys that are like, cute, and you're like, I didn't expect this, God. And before you know it, guess what, the world comes, and the world sees you, and it's like this, like those guys. All right, okay, Brianna, come here real quick, let me show you up, right? Okay, oh, Junior Ryder, oh, come here real quick. Come here, little urbanite. Let me have a talk with you. And before you know it, the world can end up bullying you. The world could end up bullying you and doing things to you. And before you know it, you didn't even expect it. But before you know it, you're entangled in the things of the world. Before you know it, you're all caught up. And if you want to be an unashamed student, if you have a desire to be an unashamed student, the first thing to do is standing up. Standing up for what you believe in. Standing up for God. Amen? And that's not just the church. That's at home. That's at school. That's with your friends. That's every single aspect of your life. Amen? And I remember when I was in junior high, there was a bully named Richie Soto. I remember his name. Hey, man, I don't know about you, but he overcame death. He overcame the world. And he's a lot bigger than who they call the Mocoso, also known as Big Red. And so you guys laugh. You're like, oh, it's a gum and the devil. I get it. God is able. God is able to get you through anything, junior higher, sixth grader, seventh grader. If you feel like you can't do it, like you can't stand up to God, God's gonna back you up. All you gotta do is be like, hey, Jesus, are you the man? Right? Or whatever, however you say it. Like, and however you wanna say it, all I know is that God has your back. And you know what? So does your brother. So does your sister. So does the person to your left and to your right. Together, we can overcome the world. Amen? Amen. So let me ask you this. Why is it important to live right? We kind of talked about it a little bit. But why is it important to act right? You want to know why? Because check this out. The Bible says take your everyday ordinary life and do it right. Live for God. Stand up for God. And here's examples and things that happen when you don't. Number one, people won't receive from you. If you say, hey, I'm a Christian, and I serve God, I love God, and like you're preaching to someone like, yeah, Jesus can get you. What, fool? What are you looking at? Or like, are you just start like fighting people while you're trying to witness? You think that person's going to listen to you? That person's going to be like, what? I ain't even saved. Or what about, or do you guys have like, I have like an uncle? I'm a son of Jesus. Or you are a representation of your church, right? So you are. You guys come to this junior high winter retreat and you guys like pull out like all kinds of like mud or I don't know what. You guys start pulling up all kinds of things and throwing them at people's faces. Are you being a good reflection or representation of the church? No? That's what your pastor does, like as a sign of love or something. I love you. You guys we gotta make sure together, we gotta make sure that we are representing Christ correctly. We gotta make sure it. Otherwise, we're giving off false information. We're giving off a false image of who God is. Amen? Amen? Praise the Lord. Okay, so here's the deal. You're standing up for God. You're like, that's it. I'm doing this. I've purposed it in my heart. I'm gonna serve God. And so you got your What Would Jesus Do bracelet. You got your little necklace with the fish.